skating with unbridled passion. France's Anacina and Pesara, heroes in their homeland, capturing a nation's heart with breathtaking performances on the ice. They were the overwhelming favorites heading into these World Championships. Italy's Fuscipoli and Mergaglio skate with heat and dramatic flair. This season's battles have been won by the French. But a small slip by Pesara in the original dance has vaulted the Italians into the lead. Ice dancing's tale of romance, intrigue, and triumph will unfold next. Not hard to understand why Nice and the south of France have inspired so many painters and writers and poets. And if you can't get a good meal here, well, you just don't like to eat. Great French cuisine all over the place. And we welcome you back inside the Palais des Expositions. Another battle to be waged for the gold medal here as the ice dancers step out onto the ice here at the World Figure Skating Championships. Hi again, everybody. I'm Terry Gannon. Before we get to the free dance, we have good news to report about the young Ukrainian pair skater that you saw take a horrible fall earlier in our show. Dmitry Palomarchuk, after being taken to a hospital, being checked out by the doctors, a CAT scan was done, and happy to report there is no damage, and the doctors say he's going to be just fine. Right now, we welcome in two-time U.S. ice dancing champion Susie Wynn. And Susie, if there was one given coming into the world, a lock, you could take it to the bank, and Anacina and Pesara of France would win the gold medal here in their home country. Hold on a minute. They're in second place with a lot of work to do.
It was a big surprise, really, because Marina and Gwendal had won the European Championships just recently. They were actually world silver medalists last year. So everyone thought they're dominating this season. Hey, they're going to keep that going. But in the original dance, there were mistakes. Gwendal tripped in one of the required footwork sequences in this phase of the competition. His body got ahead of his feet, and what seems to be a small error really cost them the lead.
So not only some work to do to come from behind in second place right now, but even more pressure skating here at home. It's the Italians in the lead. Fuscipoli and Mergaglio, they've been red hot and on the move all season.
Red hot's a great word to describe this Italian team. They were fifth last year at the World Championships, and now they're not only in contention for a medal, but they're going for first place. They're fiery, they are aggressive, and they are not afraid of the French team at all. In fact, they said to the French, hey, be careful of us at the World Championships.
Yeah, they said they came here to win, not to finish second. Well, in light of what's taken place away from the ice this week here in Nice, and the fact that Anacina and Pesara have absolutely been mobbed everywhere they've gone, security has been heightened in the arena and around it. For more on that, let's check in with Leslie Visser now.
Terry, in light of the attack on the French pair skater Stéphane Bernardy, the organizing committee has increased the protection. There are now more than 140 security personnel assigned to the hotels, the arena, and the individual skaters. This is the first time in memory that anyone can recall bodyguards being assigned to the ice dancers. But Gwendal Pesara said this is not just a physical comfort, but a mental comfort as well. Terry?
Leslie, thank you. Right now, the standings heading into the free dance. Fuscipoli and Mergaglio trying to pull off the upset over the French team, and a great battle being waged for the bronze medal. Lobacheva and Averbuch of Russia taking on Drobiazko and Vanagas of Lithuania.
On the ice, representing the United States of America,
and out there first, their first trip to the Senior World Championships from the U.S., Jamie Silverstein and Justin Pekarek, and in a very solid 13th place. Great future for this young American team.
The free dance, a four-minute program, it's worth 50% of the total score. Dancers can't rely on jumps or standard spins or moves. Every dance is original in its design, and I think it's the most innovative of all the disciplines.
You wouldn't be biased at all, would you? Third phase of the competition for the ice dancers after the compulsories and the original dance. a future these two have. After winning the 99 World Junior Championship, this season's silver medalist at the U.S. Nationals. Forget about turning heads here in Nice. They've been doing it for the past year and a half.
They are such hard workers. Not only are they talented, but they have such a strong work ethic. They've had a lot of success since they've begun skating together in 1995.
Jamie only 16 years old and Justin 18. They live and train just outside of Detroit.
Because their technique is so sound, and they both are just fine skaters. This is a change of direction lift, showing two different curves. Beautiful. Rotational lift has to turn at least three revolutions. Terry, they are so poised for being so young. Their first world championship. No problem for them.
In 14th during the compulsories, or right after, and then 13th after the original dance. So moving a little bit up the ladder, but to be in 13th at your first world championships and to be 16 and 18 years old, no question, for years we're going to be watching them at the Worlds.
Their choreography is sophisticated. Their lifting is sophisticated. Here, a very strong lift. Watch his feet. He has great partnering skills. She has wonderful flexibility and strength in her body. Just fine skating everywhere. Hear their change of direction lift. See, they're on one curve, and then they change position. They go from a high line to a low line. Great control.
Now, there's a different panel of judges for each phase of the ice dancing competition. Susie, what are they looking for here in the free dance?
Well, Terry, they're looking at the required elements. 5 to 7 lifts, 2 footwork sequences, 2 dance spins. They're looking for unison in the leg and body line. Speed and flow are also very important, and closeness and difficulty of positions in both the footwork and the choreography.
Now there'll be 2 sets of marks as they sit alongside Igor Spielmann and Liz Coates, who run the mecca of ice dancing in the U.S. in Detroit. First set now, Susie.
I think the 4-8 and the 4-9 are quite low because the first mark is technical merit. This program is more difficult than a lot of the free dances we're going to see.
Youngsters, maybe the judge is not yet ready to give them that next level of marks. Presentation marks now.
Well, these are very nice, and they should just be pleased with how they skated. Next year, it'll be a different story.
But in first, in terms of those that have skated here in the free dance, their American counterparts are next. Naomi Lang and Peter Chernyshev, twice the U.S. champs and the reigning champs. Comes from a great skating family. Peter's grandfather, a great Russian skater in the 30s, and Naomi wants to go to school to become a veterinarian. First things first, they'll take the ice here in Nice when we come back. Back at the World Figure Skating Championships, Terry Gannon, Susie Wynn ringside, the free dance underway, and the American champions out onto the ice right now. In eighth place, after the original dance, Naomi Lang and Peter Chernyshev.
The music, anytime, anywhere, performed by Sarah Brightman. Difficult. They're using such unusual dance holds in a mirror picture.
Peter Chernyshev, part of the wave of skaters that have come to the United States from Russia. He should have his U.S. citizenship in time for the 2002 Olympics.
Choreographed by Christopher Dean, the 1984 Olympic gold medalist. Very intricate and super choreography. Positions.
They've had a terrific year, especially the second half. Their second straight win at the U.S. National Championships this year in Cleveland, and then their first major international win in Japan at the Four Continents Championship.
About this free dance was that they skated it with so much more real emotion. Their confidence is growing, and deservedly so.
It seemed authentic, didn't it?
It really did.
Received a perfect 6.0 for presentation for their free dance at the Nationals. Team on the move from the States, Naomi Lang and Peter Chernyshev.
This team is just so gifted. Look at this beautiful lift. His turning abilities, he's tight in his feet, he's got so much control. She has so much beauty and flexibility through her body line. That takes years and years to work on. She was a ballet dancer for 12 years, and you could see that experience shining through. The change of direction lift, one of the specified lifts you can see here on one foot, he's on a deep curve that takes, again, that control and strength and great skill over the blade into their final position.
On the left of your screen, there's Chris Dean. He and Jane Torval with 56 perfect 6.0s at the World Championships throughout their careers. First set.
These marks are disappointing. 5.1, to me, that is seriously a joke. This team has incredible difficulty. They're beautiful skaters. Somebody's missing the boat here.
And the presentation marks put Lang and Chernyshev currently in third place. They are not pleased. So it comes down to this, the crowd getting a glimpse now of Marina Anasina and Gwendal Pelissera from France. They skate for gold after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Championships continue on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Back in Nice at the World Figure Skating Championships. The free dance with the final group on the ice warming up. With the gold medal about to be decided. Listen to this crowd here. Why? Well, Anasina and Pelissera, the last two seasons, silver medalists at the World Championships and the overwhelming favorites for the gold medal here in Nice, but needing to come back. They're in second place right now. The last two seasons, they finished behind Angelika Krylova and her partner Olga Gatsyanikov. She's injured. Serious back injury, a neck injury. Her career in question, she told Leslie Visser here in Nice the other day. Well, a reminder, tomorrow right here. So here we go. The five-time French champions, the European champs. This is supposed to be their time to shine, their time to win gold, and do it in their home country. Marina Anasina and Gwendal Pelissera. Music, Carmina Burana.
Very passionate free dance. The story is the faith against virtue.
Anasina, originally from Moscow. Gwendal Pelissera, right here in France. They live and train in Lyon, only 4 hours from here. We'll be right back.
of this crowd really is extraordinary.
Sheer French magic right here on the French Riviera. They talked all week long about how happy they were to skate here at home, but about how much pressure that brought. And with all of the attention through their practices, walking around the building, going back to their hotel, anywhere they went, they were just mobbed. The extra security. This was a very difficult world championship for Anicina and Krejcová. But what images they created. There is Marina's mother, Irina. Yeah, go ahead and cry.
The nerves entered in a little bit here in this rotational lift. Again, watch Gwendal's right foot. He just loses his footing and his balance, but they recuperate so well to go on to have an extraordinary performance. And one thing that they've popularized along with Christopher Dean is the roll reversal lift. Marina lifts Gwendal. Very strong and a great crowd-pleasing lift.
Susie, you've said ice dancing, especially the free dance, about creating a mood and a spirit out there. They do it as well as anyone. Now the first set of marks.
I think some of the judges saw that bobble, and they couldn't give them the 5.9 that I thought they deserved.
Got to think that presentation marks, though, will be higher. They always are. Hey, how about four perfect 6.0s?
This program choreographed by Christopher Dean and Jane Torval, and they've handed down their 6.0 legacy to this team.
They're only 52 behind Christopher Dean right now, but this crowd doesn't care. And Anicina Pejera into the lead right now. And amid the pandemonium, the Italians, Barbara Fuscher-Poli and Maurizio Magalio, try to stay composed as they make their way out to take the ice next. Now will become part of the French crowd, watching and waiting to see if they hold on to the gold medal here. And a reminder, tomorrow on ABC Sports, the Italian challengers, who actually have the lead after the original dance, this crowd has yet to quiet down after the performance of Anicina and Pejera. Tough, tough act to follow. But here are Barbara Fuscher-Poli and Maurizio Magalio.
The music, Lord of the Dance, and Braveheart.
Start of the season, they really started to send a message that they were not going to be a fifth place team at the World Championships this season. Two wins in the Grand Prix Series, finished just behind Anicina and Pejera at Europeans. And Barbara made the comment right after the original dance, we are absolutely here to win. We're not thinking about second.
That's the attitude to have. You can see it in their skating.
Maurizio completed his duty in the Italian army, and they credit much of their success this year to the fact that they have more training time.
It makes a big difference. They took all of last summer to really work on their own individual skills. And that can't hurt you at all when you come back into your couple.
Impressed with that, and the reaction from the French crowd here too. This is a great reaction. And of course, Italy less than an hour from here, so there are probably a lot of fans that have crossed the border. Cucciapoli and Bargaglio were not conservative. They didn't hold back. Followed up the French team here at home.
They started off so strong. Everything was exact, precise. Look at the strength. The picture is held. Just so strong. And here at the end of their program, look, here he lifts on 1 foot. Great balance. She in a stag position. Everything they did, they were just totally committed to.
Four perfect sixes may be too much to ask. But we'll wait and see. First set for technical merit now.
Terry, I think the 5-7s are a little bit low, the 5-6 very low. This was a very well-skated, well-put-together program. Not as difficult as Anasina and Pazara, but still warranting better marks than that.
Yeah, 5-6 from the Hungarian judge. And the presentation marks, there they are. The crowd now realizing that it's not Cucciapoli and Bargaglio, but Anasina and Pazara, who now have the lead. You cannot take anything away from the Italian duo, though. They cannot be unhappy or ashamed at all about what they have done here. But look at the fans. What, did the Beatles just show up?
That's what I was going to ask you, Terry.
Wow. So now, the battle for the bronze medal. The Russians, Irina Lobacheva and Ilya Amburbu, twice the Russian national champions. They've been married for 3 years. And of course, Amburbu used to skate with Marina Anasina with his new partner and his wife. He'll take the ice looking for a bronze when we come back. Welcome back to Nice in the World Figure Skating Championships. The free dance has come down to the battle for the bronze medal now, most would think. Irina Lobacheva and Ilya Averbuch of Russia in third after the original dance. Two-time Russian national champions.
Jesus Christ Superstar is a program that they competed with in the 1998 season. They struggled making some choices, so they went back to an old program.
Lobacheva and Averbuch just ahead of Drobiazko and Vonegas of Lithuania. And if the Russians do not land on the podium, it would be the first time since 1968 that there is not a Russian or Soviet dance team on the podium at Worlds.
A lot of pressure on these two. They feel that.
Thank you.
finished fourth at the Worlds the last two seasons. But they've had so many problems this year. The shoulder injury, the arena, the programs early on were not well received. And then a fourth place finish at the European Championships in Vienna. Married couple that's had a season of adversity. Lobacheva and Averbuch with all the Russian hopes on their shoulders, trying to meddle here and hold off the Lithuanian team.
You could tell that they were very much at home with this program. They skated it very well, very solidly. Here in their change of direction lift, good form, nice straight lines. They skated with great flow in and out of all of their elements here in one of their final lifts. Some of the lifts that they did were a little bit more simple, but very well executed.
Sitting alongside Natalia Linichuk and Gennady Karpinosov, the 1980 Olympic ice dancing gold medalist, and their coaches, the first set for technical merit, 5.5 to 5.7, Susie.
Thank you.
Well, these seem quite fair. The program, they skated it well, but some of the moves were a little bit more simple.
And now waiting for the second set. Presentation marks 5.7 up to a 5.9. Very high. You see all the judges' placements. Third place. So for the moment, Lobacheva and Averbuch in third trying to hold on. So now it's up to the team from Lithuania. Margarita Drobiazko and Povilas Vanagas, the bronze medalists at Europeans, who will be married pretty soon. Ironically, they live and train in Moscow, trying to keep the Russians off the podium. They'll take the ice after this message and a word from our ABC stations. The bronze medal on the line. Right now, Anasina and Pezara over Fusopoli and Morgalio. Lobacheva and Averbuch of Russia in third. We'll see what Margarita Drobiazko and Povilas Vanagas can do here in their free dance. They are in fourth after the original dance.
Dance lift.
started the season so well with their first international win at Skate Canada. Third place finish at the Grand Prix Final, where they beat Lobachev and Avabouk. And a third at Europeans. They beat them there as well.
They keep improving. This team works very hard, and they have great emotion. Do most of their own choreography. You can tell it's just very authentic, very real. You sense the tension that builds between them. Their circular footwork traveling clockwise. Most teams skate the more comfortable way, counterclockwise. So they're really so capable, going for something that's not as comfortable. Very effective.
They finished sixth at the World Championships last year, trying to become the first skaters from Lithuania to win a world medal in any discipline.
Rotational lift. They didn't hold back. It looks like they want that bronze medal.
So the question is, who do you like sitting at home watching, the Lithuanians or the Russians? Jovianko and Vonnegut, their effort here in the free dance will come back with their marks to see if they capture the bronze, or will it be Lobachev and Avabouk? We'll find out in a moment. Who will wear the bronze? Margarita Jovianko, Povilas Vonnegut. The first set, Susie.
Their program was so intricate and difficult. I actually thought the marks should have been a little higher.
And the all-important presentation marks. Lobachev and Avabouk in third right now. Boy, it's got to be a long wait for the skaters. Here are the presentation marks, and they get it.
Oh, that's got to feel good. Those 5.9s, they really, they just shared their emotions with us, and that is so important.
Six out of the nine judges placing them third, so it is Jovianko and Vonnegut edging out the Russians for the bronze medal. But they won't storm the Bastille or tear this building down. It's the French team winning it. Anastina and Pejeron, the favorites coming in. They had to come from behind, though, to beat Barbara Fuster-Poli and her partner, Mauricio Margaglio.
I was second. I not the next year.
Ooh. Anastina Pejeron, the gold medal for the first time. Fuster-Poli and Margaglio jump from fifth to second this season. Trebiasco and Vonnegut's a great race with the Russians. They wear the bronze medal. The Americans, Langen Chernyshev, eighth. Silverstein and Pekarik finished 12th. Let's go to Leslie right now.
Terry, after years in the shadow, they have stolen the spotlight only 4 hours from home. Congratulations to both of you. Try to describe the emotion out there, Gwendal.
Impossible to describe. I think the public was amazing. They were so loud and so supporting for us. That was cool.
What did you know that you did well?
Today we skate really well and we're so happy what's happened. And, you know, yesterday we did little mistakes and we were second. And it was first time in all season this year and it was so long. So today we tried to concentrate more and we did our job great and we're so happy.
And what does that program say about you two? What are you trying to say in it?
It shows how two very different spirits can go along together with, you know, with different point of view, but getting to the same point.
Well, it was so passionate, so exciting. Congratulations to you, and you ended the Russian rule. Back to you, Terry.
Thanks, Leslie. Anastina and Pejeron, the first French team to win the World Championship in ice dancing since 91, the Duchesnes. Back with a final word next. The world champions, Marina Anastina, Gwendal Pejeron, stand and listen to La Marseillaise, the French national anthem. Susie Wynn, Peggy Fleming, Dick Button, and Leslie Vischer. I'm Terry Gannon. One final time, so long from Nice. ABC Sports is online at abcsports.com, part of the Go Network.